ufunda kuncwadi yabaseThesalonika wokuqala chapter 2 verse 13.
First Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 13.
Verse 13.
Yes.
Ngenxa yoko nathi sibulela kuye uThixo singayeki.
Yes.
Okokuba nathi ukulamkela ilizwi likaThixo lodaba kuthi analamkela lililizwi labantu. Nalamkela njengokuba kunjalo okwenyaniso. Lililizwi likaThixo elisebenzayo nokusebenza kuni bakholwayo.
Believing God. We have to believe God.
To believe, it is about your mind. It holds your mind. It means your mind is convinced till that it has grasped this, such that nobody else can persuade you away from
this.
Believe Jesus Christ. These people, they believe God. Jesus Christ is the Lord. Let your mind not debate this. Jesus Christ is not a failure at all. The word, many people, they read the word, they don't believe it. They look at impossible things. The word of God, the moment you believe it, the word I spoke in the beginning about believing in Jesus. In John chapter number 1. Read there.
Ekuqalekeni ube ekho ulizwi.
Yes.
Waye ulizwi ekuye uThixo. Waye uThixo. Waye ulizwi enguThixo. Verse 2.
Yes.
Yena lowo ebekho ekuqalekeni kuThixo.
Read in English.
Funda ngesiNgesi.
In the beginning was the word.
In the beginning was the word.
Ekuqalekeni wayekhona ulizwi.
Believe that.
Ikholelwe lonto.
In the beginning.
Ekuqalekeni
was the word.
Wayekhona ulizwi.
Was not a problem.
Yayingayingxaki.
Was the word.
Wayengulizwi.
Before you come in into that problem, that is why a believing believer, greater things will happen in his life. Before AIDS came, there was the word. Before poverty came, before cancer came, there was the word. That is why when attacks come in you, stretch the muscles of believing. Go back. When things were still right, as you go back, you are going to the Alpha. Be there in the Alpha. In the Alpha. Before AIDS attacks you. Before poverty attacks you. Before you desire to kill yourself. Go back. You will get away. Stand there. Begin to look your giants. Look your AIDS. Look poverty. Look your giants. Look your enemies. A word will come that says,
before you were
able, I selected you. I chose you. And what happens in you? Power comes.
Yes, Lord
the
Jesus.
The
devil is in problem
today.
Some of you, God, to namhlanje,
but today,
ndibalanda ekuqaleni. Ndibalanda. Ndibalanda ngo Yesu. Ndibalanda egameni lika Yesu.
In the name of Jesus. Akhosama. Komala. Reba khashaye nemoshiko. Yes, my father.
You go back.
Oboya lomfa.
That is why.
Yiyangelendo.
The Bible says.
Bible is saying.
If any man is in Christ.
Ubani ku Christ.
He's a new creature.
Usisidalwa esitsha.
You begin to be new.
Usuka wena ube mtsha.
Like never before.
Ngaphezulu kwabo kasekuqaleni.
You become new.
Sokube mtsha.
Why?
Oba.
One. You believe, and your believing has taken you back into the Alpha. That is why Jesus was sent to restore you, to bring you back, to restore what the devil has stolen. So Jesus has fixed every mess. When he died, he was dealing with you, reconciling, restoring. How will this work in you? Believe. Believe. That is why many people, they change very late. Because they delay themselves from believing. They don't believe. The moment you believe, something will happen in your life.
No,
Baba kubambile. Kule meko cimba sozuphume. Lithi mina.
You will get out
only by believing. In the beginning was the way. You must believe that.
Why are you calling me?
Why are you calling
me? He was there in the beginning.
The word was with God. The word was God. People,
abantu,
for them to believe. That is why I have been speaking in the beginning here. That we must have praying people. They will pray for people to believe. To believe in God and to believe in His word. We need intercessors. That's why here there are people who struggle to believe. Your mind is possessed by the spirit of unbelief. Is holding you. You have got a problem. Some are grasped by an ancestral spirit. They want to believe. But they don't believe this. They don't believe Jesus. They believe Damkulu. That's why many, they dream the dead people. Their mind was stolen to believe on the dead people. You are not a person to dream the dead. You must dream angels. That's why every time you dream dead people, it's because your mind is not believing on heaven things. It's believing more on the dead.
likholelwa kukhona kwabafileyo. Yeah.
In the book of 2 Corinthians,
we know the Bible Corinthians.
The Bible says,
"In Bible it,
the God of this age."
Oh, tito ka ngawe liqesha.
Read the first. 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Read, Dolly.
2
Corinthians 4.
What the Bible Corinthians besbin?
Yes.
Chapter 4.
Yes, first, my dear us.
Verse 4. Athe uThixo weliphakade wazimfamekisa ngaphakathi kwabo ingqiqo zabanga.
Start on verse 3.
Verse 3. Ukuba ke ziqutyuthelwe indaba ezilungileyo zethu, ziqutyuthelwe kwabo abatshabalalayo.
Many people,
abantu abaninzi,
they struggle to believe the gospel.
Why am I not going to?
Why, Mamuncha? There is a veil. The devil brings a veil. So that you don't believe the gospel. You struggle to believe. He says, even if our gospel is veiled. It is veiled to those who are perishing. Because the moment you don't believe, you don't believe God's word, you don't believe Jesus, you perish. You perish. And why? The devil is put a veil so that you don't see clearly the things of God. And the devil loves you when you don't see clearly. That is why, for you to pray, you struggle. For you to kneel down to pray, you struggle. Why? You don't believe. You don't know what will happen when you are from prayer. For you to go to church, you struggle. Why? You don't believe. For you to read the word, you struggle. Because you think it's just a book. You don't know that this is God's word. And the reason is, the devil has put a veil. So that when you say, I'm going to read the Bible, you begin to postpone it. You struggle. Why? The veil. And the Bible says,
why for the Bible?
Even if our gospel is veiled, it means it is not veiled. But to those who perish, those who don't believe, they suffer. They see the gospel as useless. They don't believe. Some of you here, they are spouses. They don't believe in Jesus. But prayer will soften their hearts. Will remove the scales.
The scales
of prayer. Paul says, I urge you, brothers, that request, prayers, and petitions be made for people to believe, for people to be born again,
because this is good and it glorifies God. It may seem as if all those may be saved,
but because they don't believe, the veil is there. And the verse says, the God of this age,
Uthixo Put it there. The God of this age has blinded the minds. So if your mind doesn't believe, it doesn't hold what God is saying. You hear by your ears, but your mind doesn't hold. That is why you don't dream what is in your mind. Your mind doesn't have the word. So your mind has got the past. As a result, you see the past instead of what God is saying. But I feel a door of believing is going to open. There are people to believe God. They won't believe God for small things. They will believe God for greater things. The Bible says, those who believe, they are God, they will do exploits. Believing God. So the Bible says, the devil has blinded the minds so that they cannot see the light of the gospel. There is no better thing than the gospel. I'm about to pray now. I say to you, there is nothing better
that will surpass the gospel.
Nothing better than
the gospel of God.
You may
go and tell your devil,
I say
there is nothing that will outweigh the gospel.
The gospel carries the future. The gospel carries healing. The gospel carries eternity. But the problem is, you don't believe it. It carries future. It carries redemption. It carries success. We have seen people. The future is being
demolished by people. But when he believed in the way,
the moment he believed,
and I believe,
and I declare, my life will never
be the same.
Believe,
Kholwa,
I was a mess.
Dandi nyaka nyaka nje.
You were the mess.
Awe futhi ilo nyaka nyaka.
Do you remember?
Yes, Lord.
Do you remember?
Usakhumbula na?
Those days.
Wenzo mini?
When you were a rubbish.
Wena kanje wayimfungu mfungu.
Do you remember?
Usakhumbula?
When you were in hospital.
Wena kanje wena usesibhedlela.
Do you remember?
Usakhumbula?
When you were in accident.
Wena kanje ngozi.
Do you remember?
Usakhumbula?
When enemies were facing you.
Lonke imitshaba zakho zijongele nawe.
God was able to secure you those days. How can he leave you now? If God, who kept you, help me, Holy Spirit, for these people to believe God. Do you remember the day you were naked? Somebody came to you and wrapped you. He gave you milk. Do you remember when you were in your mother's womb? If God kept you, you had no mind. You had no wisdom. You were just in the stomach. But the heavens kept you. Now,
ngoku,
you are wise now.
Unabulumko.
You don't want to believe God.
Awufuna ukumkholela uThixo.
UThixo wakugcina usesibelekweni.
But God will keep you no mother's womb.
Ungenazo nempahla waphuma unganxiba.
You were naked and you came out naked.
UThixo wavusa umuntu.
And God raised a man.
Ongumzali wakho.
Who is your parent?
Wangabona nobuze wena.
Who didn't see if, even if you
are but naked? But the day se uqala ukuzegquma ucima ubhahle.
The day that you wrap yourself, you think, who do you think you are?
UThixo.
God.
Oh, wakugcina use ICU.
Kept you in the ICU.
Where were you?
Wopina.
Kela kathi izulu likuphunga.
When the heaven
lisakha wena ngaphakathi.
Bending you inside.
Where were you?
Wopina.
Kela kathi izulu lifaka mehlo.
When the heaven was putting eyes on you.
Yes. Where were you?
Wopina.
Where were you?
Wopina.
The day izulu lisakha inyawo.
When the Lord built him the feet.
Inside.
Ngaphakathi.
But wakubhahla.
But when you are up, when you are
on your mind,
you don't want to believe God.
You've got a problem.
Unengxaki.
Where were you?
Uphina.
When your mother was up and down.
Wakunyoko esihle nyoka.
Ebeleka wena.
Yes, with you.
Ungena ngqondo wena.
We'll have you.
Unikwa isifuba as a flu.
Crying.
Kufanele ba waphupha.
You were supposed to.
Kodwa izulu lema.
But the heavens.
Where were you?
Uphina.
Kenge sabanye bengcwatshwa. Kodwa wena usekhona.
But you are still alive.
But now.
God can go.
You don't want to believe God.
I'll follow him call you team.
You've got a big problem. Where were you? Today when you say believe God, you say God cannot do this.
How do you do?
God who made you to breathe whilst you were in.
Oh, Thixo wathi wakwazi ukwenza uba mawuphefumle kodwa ungaphakathi.
Some of you here.
Abanye benu
are the orphans.
Bazingedwa.
They don't have parents.
Abana bazali.
But they have God who has been the father.
Kodwa kuThixo nguyise
wabo. But now.
Kodwa ngoku.
They don't want to believe God.
Abafuna ukumkholela uThixo.
Some of you here
abanye benu
are from poor families.
Basuka kwi family.
They don't have means. But God has made them to survive. God wanamhlanje kunzima ukumkholelo. Hey! Lo moya. Ukwenza ungakholwa. Dia ufayarisha. Dia ufayarisha.
In the name of Jesus.
Do you think God can fail to take care of your life? Why do you struggle to believe God? Why do you make God a failure? God who kept you.
God who said that even before you were conceived,
now
I knew you.
Now you struggle to believe. You just struggle to believe. You are running away to believe. You part time in God. One who gave you oxygen. He created you. He put water. You never created water. He gave you the mind. He gave you eyes. Nakhlanje Satan uyadana. Nizomkholelwa. Awayekhona.
Those who were there before.
He created you.
Wakudala.
And he put you.
Wakubeka foot.
On earth.
Emhlabeni.
Having everything.
Unazo zonke izinto.
You came with nothing.
Wabe uze ungena nento.
You are walking on the soil that you arrived the soil to be here.
Oh, futhi usahamba emhlabeni wafika ulapha.
You brought
nothing. You eat what he created. You walk on his soil. But you still not believe in God.
Yes, Lord. Why do you struggle to believe God?
Kungoba kutheni lento senza nzima ukukholwa kuthi?
Is there anything that God cannot do?
Engabi khona into uThixo ongena kuyenza.
God who handles sun.
UThixo uthi futhi abambe abantu.
Sun.
Ilanga.
Every day, it rises.
Yes, Lord.
Every day, it runs and goes down for people to see. And by night, they sleep. And God watches. Whilst they sleep. And then the morning sun comes.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
God who takes care.
Don't
you know that it is the blindness of the devil for you not to believe God? Every day God makes sure that he sends oxygen. You cannot buy it. Don't you know that is the enemy who makes you not to believe God, that God can change your life? Do you think that God can fail or can leave the devil to do what he wants on your life forever?
Never.
Do you think that God doesn't see the devil? Do you think the devil?
Yes, Lord.
Do you think that your enemies have won? Never.
Aye,
your problem is don't believe God. But today, you will believe him. In him, all things are possible. I say in him.
What is impossible?
Possible to God. We are called now.
Do you believe?